That
just means that you're radiating, Governor. That's
yeah,
all.
Yeah, thank you very much. What's she saying about?
Oh, she wants to make sure you look good.
I need help.
You'll be fine, Governor. Thanks very much. What does it mean for you to talk to the Senate cadets here, especially young and upcoming Republicans?
It's just wonderful. I love this place. Senate has a grand and well-deserved reputation. It is a wonderful school. It is unique, and to be here with these young men and women, and Republicans as well, is always a thrill. I always enjoy hearing about the Senate, visiting the Senate, and I'm very proud.
What do you think is what's the mood of the Republican Party right now, sir? Because there is a lot of conflict in Washington. It seems like politics is just so muddy these days.
Well, it is muddy, but of course that's politics. But we have a strong leader in Donald Trump who knows exactly where he wants to go. He's not confused about what he wants to do. His principles are sound. And I think that we are going to make America greater than ever before. And I see it right here in South Carolina. Just in the time I've been lieutenant governor in the governor's office, I've seen these companies coming in from all over the world that can't get enough of South Carolina. Big ones invested millions, hundreds of millions, and billions of dollars. And they all rave about the strength of the people. And just that's reflected right here in the strength of the people. This institution right here produces strong people, and that's what we're doing.
Governor, there was a big shakeup in Columbia this week with David Pascoe. He handed down those indictments against all those people. How's that going to affect the campaign and the public's trust in government?
Well, that you're right. Public trust is very important, and often it's very fragile. So what we must do in these kinds of things, from charges or serious charges or fraud, we just have to let the system run its course, and that's the only way that the people have confidence and trust in the government.
Do you think your former strategist, Rick Quinn, do you think he's done anything wrong? Do you still like him? Do you still keep in touch with him?
Well, like I say, we must, in order to have trust in the government, investigations can't be hurried. They shouldn't be hurried. They shouldn't be slowed down. You just have to let them run their course. That's important.
Could this hurt the upcoming legislative session? Pre-filing starts here in December, and of course, we're back at it again here in January.
I think there'll be a lot of activity. I know that the economic growth of our state is vitally important. We're on the cusp of economic growth and prosperity that we haven't seen before. I think there will be an enormous amount of activity in the legislature trying to tighten up laws. I want to cut taxes down. I want people to have bigger paychecks, and I want more of them. And we have to, in order to do that, we have to get our taxes down lower to make us more competitive. We've got to get rid of regulations that are strangling, especially the small businesses. We have things we have to overcome in education. We can do that. We have to be sure that people are safe so they can work. We have, all together, we have more assets and more opportunity than other states. And I know with Scanner and Sandy Cook, a situation there as well, there's a lot of interest in South Carolina. Big companies from around the world that are interested in becoming a power structure that is the electric power structure in South Carolina. So I think there'll be an enormous amount of activity. And what I hope to do is to encourage that, make recommendations, encourage legislation to get the people educated and get them jobs and good companies with bigger paychecks and more of them and less taxes. And I really don't think there's another state in the country that can keep up with
us. Last question, sir. Do you worry that there could be more indictments handed down here?
Is this those things, you just have to let those things take their course in order for people to have trust. Just have to let them take the course. But what I want more of is more prosperity, and I know that we have it within our grasp right now. If we can reduce those taxes, have them low as we can, get rid of the regulations, and we have to educate the young people about it. But if we do just a few simple things like that and keep the government out of the way, we can have an economic prosperity that we've never seen before. And that's what I'm concentrating on.
And do you trust David Pascoe?
I trust our legal system. It was evolved over many centuries, as you know, and I trust our legal system in the United States. It's the best one there is in the whole world.
Anything else you'd like to add, sir?
It's a happy day to be in Charleston. It's a happy day to be in at the Citadel. And it sure is a wonderful time to be living, working, raising children in South Carolina. And I think it's the best place in the whole world, and I can't tell you how proud I am of our people.
Thank you, Governor. Take care of Zach. Take care of Zach. Yep. Okay.